So, question for you. Does Donald Trump want to give wealthy Americans a tax cut or not? Observers say he is reversing a policy that would give rich Americans a break, but Trump hitting back hard, saying his plan was just a starting point and that the final policy will only come after negotiations with Congress. Take a listen.
It seemed as though you were saying this weekend two things that were different from what you've said in the past. One on taxes for the wealthy, where you said you were open to taxing them more. As you know, that's against the conservatives.
I didn't say that, Chris.
Well, that's how it's being reported. Tell us.
NBC misrepresented, and Chuck Todd, if they put out that clip, I said that I may have to increase it on the wealthy. I'm not going to allow it to be increased on the middle class. Now, if I increase to the wealthy, that means they're still going to be paying less than they pay now. I'm not talking about increasing from this point. I'm talking about increasing from my tax proposal.
And as a reminder, here is what Trump told NBC yesterday.
Which is it? Are you willing to raise taxes on the 0.1%?
No, no, no. Let me explain. The thing I'm going to do is make sure the middle class gets good tax breaks, because they have been absolutely shunned. The other thing, I'm going to fight very hard for business. For the wealthy, I think, frankly, it's going to go up. And you know what? It really should go up.
All right. Joining me now, CNN Global Economic Analyst and Time Assistant Managing Editor Rana Foroohar. Rana, good morning to you.
Good morning.
So first off, just looking at those two clips back to back, what's your take? Has Trump contradicted himself on raising taxes for the rich or not?
Well, he's contradicted himself quite a lot. I mean, one of the famous things that he put forward early in his campaign was getting rid of the carried interest provision, which allows hedge funders and people that basically make money from money to pay a much lower tax rate than many of us. That still may be in play. He's actually talked about lowering tax rates on many different groups of Americans, upper class, middle class, working class, and the corporate rate. But the problem is you can't lower taxes without also cutting spending. So both the Tax Foundation and the Tax Policy Center, two big think tanks that study tax policy of all the candidates, have said that under Trump's plan, we would actually lose about $10 trillion of tax revenue without actually cutting federal spending. So you would end up with a greater deficit than we have now. And that's really the rub here. It's a very Reaganesque plan where people are talking about lowering taxes but not actually cutting federal spending to go along with it, which leaves you in the same problem that you have now.
So you're saying basically the only way that this could work is if he comes up with a proposal on where he's going to cut spending.
Absolutely. I mean, that's what happened during the Reagan era. You had a lot of tax cuts, and that's always been a big Republican economic point. You cut taxes, it's good for the economy. Well, for starters, if you cut taxes, you also have to cut spending. And point number two, cutting taxes in the last 10 or 15 years actually hasn't caused the economy to grow. If you look back at the Bush tax cuts of 2001, 2003, and even some of the Obama tax cuts, you didn't get a big kick up in growth from those moves. So this idea of trickle-down economics, which a lot of Republicans still go by, there's not a lot of proof that it works. Really, the math is simple. If you cut taxes, you have to cut spending too.
So Trump is basically saying that taxes for the wealthy would go up from his current plan, not from where taxes are right now as part of the negotiation process with Congress, but middle-class tax cuts would not go up. So what do you think about that, though? The middle class not going up, but for the wealthy going up from where it is now in his plan?
Well, so I think that you hit on the key point, which is that this is all about a negotiation with Congress, okay? Which, you know, this is the thing that Donald Trump is unproven on. You know, he has no experience going in and negotiating on tax policy, which is incredibly contentious, particularly when you get into loopholes around middle-class tax deductions like the mortgage interest rate that allows us all to buy more home, perhaps, than we should because the debt is tax deductible. These things are very politically contentious. He has to close those loopholes and do a lot of negotiating to do that, and the jury is very much out on whether he can.
All right, Rana Foroohar, thanks so much for breaking it down for us. We do appreciate it.
Thank you.